Hello everybody, I hope this isn't going to be too much in your face because I'm going to do all this video in one take, hopefully, he says nervously. I'm going to do this in the style of the underpaid, over in your face, slightly nauseating content farm YouTube style. You know them YouTube channels that seem to just be like really formulaic with the accent as well. I know it's bad form to slag off of the YouTube content creators, but things like What Culture is a great example. Who talk like this, and you're watching a compilation video, and they're constantly talking like this, pretending they're a newsreader. It gets really rather nauseating, and I'm struggling over my words because I find it so bloody boring. Right, first of all, what I'm gonna do is this video is going to be about top 5 things that I've noticed about that style of YouTube video, which is people reacting to culture shocks of the British. Or it might work around the other way around. Someone British might go to America and then culture shocked. Yeah, I know there was a reason why I mentioned culture and that what culture in my head. My head is just one big massive frying pan of ideas sometimes. Anyway, 5 things that I've noticed that they all seem to talk about within the first 2 videos that they do about culture shocks is taps. Taps in the UK. They've been married for a long, long time now. We do have mixer taps, but you'll still go to many, many houses, and even new build houses will still have separate hot and cold taps. Hot and cold faucets. There we are, translated for you. And the reason for this is because the water came from 2 different places back in the day. So before proper plumbed in bathrooms, really, the hot water came in later than the cold tap. So the cold would be on your mains, and then the hot water would be filled in a tank somewhere, and it was probably somewhere where you wouldn't want to drink it, the water from. So they were kept separate. Also, another reason as well, which is never really spoken of, is because the whole idea was that you filled the sink, or the basin, if you will, with water of the temperature you could wash your hands in, and then you could wash your hands and then pull the plug out, and then the water drains away. But these days, people are equally too lazy or too busy to fill the basin or sink with water. And now they just prefer to let the water flow away whilst they're washing their hands. There really was a point for having separate hot and cold taps, but it's pretty much lost these days. And really, I just think it looks better on a sink when you see a separate hot and cold tap. I just think it looks better. Anyway, what was the next thing I got to speak of? Oh yeah, and this is the bit where I'm supposed to interrupt my own compilation and talk about subscribing. Ooh, yes. Why do compilations always do that? They'll talk about one thing and then they'll go straight into, make sure you subscribe, and have fancy graphics going woo like that, and I don't have any of that, you might have gathered. What's the next thing I'm gonna talk about? Saying goodbye. No one says goodbye in the UK, and that's because we're all gay. No fans, and we all have to sing, can never say goodbye, boy. Ooh, ooh, ooh. No, 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 no. Ooh, ooh. That's embarrassing now that I've done it. I thought that might be fun to put in the video, and now most of the people have stopped watching. Bye! See, we don't say goodbye, we say bye, ta-ra, see you later, see ya. Loads of other ways, but don't really say goodbye. Goodbye is mainly only for news readers and uptight characters on TV. You may remember, maybe, you are the weakest link. Goodbye. That one, you know. We don't say goodbye. It's too formal, I think. I think that's why we don't say goodbye. I think I'm finished with the red wig now, and I'm finished with them glasses now. I've dropped them on the floor. Oh, well. One take, I am not doing this over and over and over again. Low quality value standards there. You may be wondering why I've got so few subscribers for a YouTuber who's been on YouTube for 14 years. And that's because my subscribers are the best subscribers. People who can't take a joke, well, they can bog off. Bog off brings me into Bogroll, which is not one of the top things I've seen these reaction videos of culture. But bog off, bog roll, bog off use. We like to use the word bog a lot for some reason. I say bog roll and tell people to bog off. And yes, it's quite good. What was my number 3 thing I was going to talk about? Cheers! We don't say thank you either. I might say thanks. Thank you is also quite formal. You'd only really use that in formal settings, like a job interview. You know when you're told to be yourself and everything in a job interview? No one is ever themselves in a job interview, otherwise no one would work at all, would they? No, you say cheers for everything. Whether it's not just a celebratory thing when you're in a pub and you've both got a pint or a glass of wine and you say cheers and chink your glasses. No, you say cheers for everything as opposed to thank you. It's like, cheers, bye, cheers, bye, you know, thank you, goodbye. Thank you, goodbye. Sounds far too posh, doesn't it? Sounds a bit, what's the face? It's a bit, ooh, goodbye. I spoke to Miss Clinton Havers the other day, and we waved goodbye to each other from our mansions. No one talks like that anymore. I'm finished with a short blonde wig. What else was I meant to be talking about? Patriotism. You won't see much patriotism in the UK. This is quite a shock to Americans, because they've got the flag everywhere and the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag in school. There's no way that would work in Britain or in the UK. It wouldn't even work individually. There would be no one pledging allegiance. It is a bit of a lesion. It is a bit weird. To the Scottish, English or Welsh or Irish flags. Absolutely not. It's just weird. The only time you'll see British flags like everywhere is when you go to the supermarket. Ironically, this is a German supermarket that has to put the British flag on everything, otherwise the British won't buy their food. Bit of a stretch. No, it's mainly to show that the food is of British origin, and that's not because, ooh, British is the best! Yes, I only eat the finest British avocados! Because obviously that would be ridiculous. No, it's whatever can be produced in Britain is better, just because it's had to travel less time, less area. It had to be jetted in from Japan or something, you know? If you're wanting something fresh that can be grown in this country, then sell it from this country in this country, you know? That's why Aldi and Lidl, apart from being German supermarkets, have Union Jacks almost everywhere in their shops. Right, that's patriotism. Oh, I'm doing absolutely fabulously good. I've not even hit 8 minutes yet. I nearly have, unless I've done a title sequence. No, I'm not going to bother with that. There's going to be no editing in this video. No way. Oh, by the way, we call this a lorry in the UK. Not a truck, it's a lorry. But do use the word truck. But it's usually for something that would be shorter, maybe. Well, no one says truck. Lorry sounds more substantial as well, I think. I think truck, no one really gives a... Just chuck that over there. Right, I'm on my last one now. Speedy, speedy, speedy. So people hopefully are still watching. Otherwise, I'm probably just talking to myself now. I do read the analytics. Five. Plugs, sockets and switches. Oh, yes. I don't know why I'm reading my list, because I've got a table of stuff right here along with my crabby bell. Subscribe. I usually say scrass, which means subscribe, comment, rate and share. Or share, comment, rate and subscribe. Bell, subscribe. That's what the B is for. So anyway, switches. There's loads of videos on YouTube of Americans reacting to British switches, which is very bizarre. Right, I'm going to go into the details very, very quickly. Obviously, I've not yanked this off the wall, but this is a triple one, which is quite rare, but it's normally just a double or a single you'd see on a wall. But this is all I had to hand. But there are switches on it. And the point of that is to make things safe. So, and to save money. Because these switches on your wall are usually behind a settee, or a sofa, if you will, or a couch, if you will. And obviously you have to reach beyond the wall and this, that and the other. Then you can just turn it off safely, and then whatever you've got plugged in, like the TV or anything like that, you know it's completely turned off and it's not wasting money and it's safely turned off. So if you go up to the shops, you're not going to come home to some sort of electrical fire or something. This particular one is very rare because it's got a fuse on it. This is mainly something you'd only see in the kitchen, what your cooker would be plugged into if you had an electric cooker that wasn't wired in. But yeah, there's fuses on everything, and that's so that if your appliance malfunctions, it cuts the power to that appliance or electrical equipment, whatever it is, without wiping out the entire circuit. And you're thinking, oh, hecky thump, the lamp has stopped working. Is it the light bulb? No, oh, something else has happened. And it's got three prongs on it because the top one is the earth pin. And the point of the earth pin is that anything with a metal outer casing like your toaster or your oven or anything like that, if it goes faulty, and somehow the metal casing becomes lath, it will cut out and it'll make you safe. And you live and you'll survive to tell the tale how your cooker that you got from some rando shop somewhere could have been a disaster, but you were saved because of the switches and the plugs. People often say as well on the videos, oh, but the plugs are so massive. They're so large. Why are they so big? And that's because, well rehearsed. And that's because we've got like delicious 240 volts. We can boil kettles of water in like a minute. And it's good. And that's to make sure that it can carry the load. You know what I mean? Fabulous and safe like that. And you can switch it on or switch it off. That's all good. Anything else I can say? Yeah, you won't find these in a bathroom. If you're really lucky and you stop at a fancy Airbnb, I know, get you posh people. You might have a bathroom socket and it'll just be a two-prong thing. Not too dissimilar to an American socket, actually, in the bathroom, but it'll be run at incredibly low voltage and wattage and all the rest of it. My flat that I live in does not have a shaver socket in the bathroom, which you can also use to charge your electric toothbrush with. No, it doesn't. And I have to resort to using these, which is an adapter. But these cost like a quid or a couple of pence. You know, you can get them anywhere. And you'll plug them into your normal plug elsewhere in your house, like that. And then you'll, like, do that, and then you charge it. It might look a bit janky and everything like that, but do you know what? Knowing my luck, and accidents do happen, and I'm sure they do in America, but I'm hardly sure that they're international newsworthy. If someone accidentally drops the hairdryer, straighteners, toothbrush, or whatever, in the kitchen or bathroom sink, mainly bathrooms, obviously. Ooh, that's my first major glitch in doing this all in one take. You know, at least then you won't die, you know, because it'll all safely cut off. Have I spoken about everything? Yes. Number one was taps. Then I did the stupid what culture voice thing. And then I said about goodbye, saying how we're all gainer fans. We're not really. I might be a bit. I mean, walk out the door. I can't say goodbye. I mean, are you coming or not, love? You know, is she leaving or is she not? I mean, she's go walk out the door. Maybe she's telling the bloke to leave because she wants to stay in the house. Why am I talking about Gloria Gaynor so much? Then there was the word cheers. Then I spoke about patriotism. Now, no one's really flying. Unless it's football, unless there's a big sports thing going on, or if it's the Olympics, you know, something like that, then it, like, flags everywhere. But then as soon as it's over, like, when we've lost, in the bin they go. There's no fancy schmancy, let's fill the flag this certain way, none of that sort of nuff. And then lastly, but not leastly, it was plugs, sockets and switches, I think I'm old. And oh yeah, also in the bathroom, there's no switch in the bathroom to turn the lights on. It's a pull cord, like that. A bit like the old fashioned toilets back in the day. And the reason for that is because you're supposed to clean it, you know? I mean, sorry, but I'm going to stretch this video out a bit. But the whole point of that in the bathroom is not just for safety, it's so you can clean it. Because it's probably going to be one of the dirtiest switches in your entire home, apart from your kitchen one with food and whatnot. I know it really goes round cleaning light switches, but if you do, it's very difficult to clean them, isn't it? Because you've got to get right in the little gaps and whatnot. But with a pull cord, which is what we have, which is almost like on a train, woohoo! yes, you can clean it. And then you can judge your home of how clean or dirty it is by someone's light pull switch in the bathroom. Because then you can get someone like Trish, and she'll be like, oh yeah, I've got a best mate, but she had a dirty cow. Yeah, went into a bathroom, went to turn the light on, and you know what? The toilet string was covered. It was absolutely dirty. It was filthy, absolutely rank. I couldn't go to a toilet because I thought that a pull cord was out of order. Yeah. And the reason why I did that is because I realised I had a wig left over and I hadn't used it. I shouldn't really throw that wig. It was very expensive. It was £9 off of Amazon. Anyway, thanks for watching. Subscribe, bye. Let me know in the comment section down below if you enjoyed all this one-take madness. Off.